Good morning and welcome once again to the Hour of Depression. Amen. Glad you could be here. Amen. Good to see most of your smiling faces. Some of them ain't smiling. Amen. Brother Dave, you'd be so kind.
Amen. Lord, we got to say, Lord, again, we do thank you for this day. We thank you for each and every one that's here, Lord. And a lot of people's going to come in, Lord, and got the church filled up pretty well, Lord. And that's a blessing, Lord. And,
yeah, amen.
And encouragement to each and every one of us, Lord. And for all we're here to fellowship in the Word of God and the preaching and the Father, the fellowship with you, most importantly, Lord God. And Father, we thank you for the Sunday school class and thank you for Dale and all the hard work that he's done in studying, Lord. And Father, to give us a good application of the trail of blood and the history of the Baptist, Lord. And it's very informative, and we appreciate the work that he's doing, Lord God. And bless him mightily for the work that he's done, Lord. And Father, we're looking to hear from you here in the preaching hour, Lord, that you have the pastor anointed with the message that you'd have us to have today, Lord God, to help us, Lord, to inform us, Lord, to carry us on through these vile, wicked days that we're in, that the world has put upon us, Lord God. But if we keep looking to you, these all be all good days, Lord God. And that's all important. That's what we do, commune with you and stay in close fellowship here in these days, Lord. Bless the rest of the services and each and every one that's here and here and on Facebook. And we'll thank you and praise you in the Lord Jesus Christ's name you pray. Amen.
Amen. Continue to pray for Brother Tommy. He called. He's listening on Facebook. And I'm not going to give him the high sign. Well, I'll wave anyway. And yeah. Amen. The Italian high sign. Amen. Yeah. Isn't that what you were saying there, Bro Phil?
That's right.
Yeah, that's right. Captain Jim, good to see you again.
Glad to be here.
Amen. Better half feeling any better?
No, not much. She has a low immunity system and just got down the dumps. Didn't sleep for 3 days cooking for Thanksgiving and then other things going on. And
wow.
She hadn't recovered yet.
Wow. You headed down to your boat?
Anyway. No, not today.
No. Figure as nice a day as it was, you'd probably be on the river.
We had a charter yesterday, but didn't have a pump until yesterday. We're finished until March.
Well, good to see you. Mm-hmm. And Harley Kevin and Petra is his old lady on the back. Is that what they call it? Amen.
Mrs. Old Lady.
There you go. Amen. Good to see Vic and Sambo. And maybe Derek. Amen. All right. Well, Patricia, you all have given Dale a complex. He thinks you're not coming in the morning because you don't want to hear him. He's very insulted. You're breaking his heart. He wore that bow tie just for y'all.
Careful, Dale.
Go with the shirt.
Hey, babe.
The ladies all love the bow tie. I go to grocery store.
So do those other kind. Amen. All right, we ready to try to sing a song? Anyway, keep Sister Teresa's family in prayer since she lost her uncle.
Tim was going to volunteer to be our song leader today.
Were you?
I got one song.
Okay, we'll sing a congregational and then y'all can come sing. Amen. All right. 500, when the roll was called up yonder.
There we go.
You laugh at me, I'll shoot you. How many brought your guns?
Right here.
We got
no.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Hey, Ben.
That's too big to transport.
We don't carry intel.
Yeah. Some carry and don't tell. Others carry and do tell. And, you know, I found out it's better just to keep it secret when you're around other places, because then you give the guy that might want to do you harm, you know, some advantage.
You lose a technical element.
Yeah, like when they say, give me your wallet, you just reach in your pocket, pull out.
That's right.
Amen. All right, 500. When the roll is called up yonder. Intro.
Okay.
Dun, dun, dun. Yeah, that thing.
When the trumpet of the Lord shall sound and time shall be no more, the morning breaks eternal bright and fair. When the saved of earth shall gather over on the other shore, the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there. When the roll is called up yonder, when the roll is called up yonder, when the road is called up yonder, when the road is called up yonder, I'll be there.
Come on now.
On that bright and cloudless morning when the dead in Christ shall rise.
Hear that? The dead in Christ shall rise. Amen.
The roll is called up yonder, I'll be there. When the roll is called up yonder, 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 I'll be there.
On the last.
Let us labor for the Master from the dawn till setting sun. Let us talk of all his wondrous love and care. And when all of life is over and our work on earth is done, and the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there. When the roll is called up yonder, when the roll is called up yonder, when the road is called up yonder, when the road is called up yonder, I'll be there.
Amen. Unless you're missionary Baptist, then when the road is called up yonder, I hope I'll be there. Amen. Amen. You ever ask people, you say, you know where you're going when you die? I hope to go to heaven. I always tell them, if you're hoping, you ain't a knowing. You ain't a knowing, you ain't a going. Yeah. Amen. It's a no-so salvation. That's these right. Things have I written unto you that believe on the name of the Son of God, that you may know that you have eternal life.
Amen.
Amen. Do you know? And I used to ask people, when did you get saved? But I quit doing that because everybody has a vision. Amen. You know, well, I remember back then, I was going down the road and I ate a Twinkie and I got heartburn and, you know, and I got this feeling come over me. And quit asking them when they got saved. Ask them when they got lost. Huh? What do you mean? If they ask you, what do you mean? Then they've never been saved, because you got to get lost before you can get found. Amen. Yeah, I see so much stuff in the churches, and I think there's a lot of folks sitting in church just need a good dose of salvation.
Amen.
It straighten up their home life, their family life, and everything else. Amen. Amen. All right. You young people ready?
Hey, young.
All right. You ugly people ready?
Come on. You ain't no beauty king yourself, but yeah. Yeah.
Thank you.
There, Jasmine, they make you look shiny.
Yeah.
You need to carry that around with you.
Muscle, boy.
That's funny.
Oh, ain't right, is it? It's funny, though, isn't it?
All right, ready?
Yep.
What can wash away my sin? Nothing but the blood of Jesus. What can make me whole again? Nothing but the blood of Jesus. Oh, precious is the flow that makes me white as snow. No other fount I know, nothing but the blood of Jesus. For my pardon this I see, nothing but the blood of Jesus. For my cleansing this my plea, nothing but the blood of Jesus. Oh, precious is the flow that makes me white as snow. No other fount I know, nothing but the blood of Jesus. Nothing can for sin atone, nothing but the blood of Jesus. Not of good that I had done, nothing but the blood of Jesus. Oh, precious is the flow that makes me white as snow. No other fount I know, nothing but the blood of Jesus. This is all my hope and peace, nothing but the blood of Jesus. This is all my righteousness, nothing but the blood of Jesus. Oh, precious is the flow that makes me white as snow. No other fount I know, nothing but the blood of Jesus.
Amen.
That's good.
Remember, you heard him here first. Evangelist Tim and the two Etts. Amen.
The two Etts.
Yeah. Jasmine added a little color to the group. Amen. Hallelujah.
I had a little soul, too. A little soul.
Amen. Yeah. Did good. Evangelist Tim. Amen.
See what I did there when I said white as snow?
Almost reminded me of Tony Orlando and Dawn.
I wouldn't go that far.
Yeah. Linda and I went to one of those concerts up in Pittsburgh one time. I'll tell you what, they put on a good show, though. I really did. I like Tony Orlando. Amen. Dawn wasn't so bad themselves. Amen. All right, Sambo, you got to cheer up and smile. You're in church now. Amen. There you go. That's better. Amen. All right, if you got your Bibles, turn to Deuteronomy chapter 28. Deuteronomy in chapter 28. You know, we like to joke around and all. Some of you probably could tell that. But this country's in serious trouble. Amen. And you know, it's the church's fault. We've let a lot of things slip. Israel, God gave Israel some cursings and blessings. Amen.
Bless them if they did what they were supposed to do, and curses if they didn't. He gave it all to them in the book of Deuteronomy. And wasn't long after they got out of Deuteronomy, they was in trouble already. Amen. When he was getting the law on the mount, it wasn't long before they were in trouble at the bottom. Amen. And all the people that came out of Egypt all weren't saved as far as Jews. Amen. There were strangers that came out with them, and they stirred up strife in the wilderness and said, you know, we brought us out here to die, and they were going to make them a captain and go back and everything. You're going to have the same thing in the church. Amen. You're going to have people in the church that, for whatever reason, they might not be saved, but they've got a attitude all the time. Sometimes they keep it subtle. I think I heard a message one time preached on wolves in sheep's clothing. Amen. And the bottom line is they just lost. And they struggle and they're not happy with themselves, so that makes them not happy with anybody. Amen. Sometimes you've got things going on in the church, even small churches like this, you have it going on. People whispering to other people. Amen. Causing strife, stirring things up. Huh?
You've been suckered.
Yeah, suckered by Zucker. But anyway, God laid out some blessings, and then he laid out some cursings. And I'm telling you what, this is some pretty serious stuff. Hey, Ben.
It wasn't me.
Surprise, surprise. Everybody. All right, Deuteronomy chapter 28. Let's begin reading in verse 1. And it shall come to pass that thou shalt hearken diligently unto the voice of the Lord thy God, to observe and to do all his commandments which I command thee this day, that the Lord thy God will set thee on high above all nations of the earth. You know, he did that for America. America sat high for a long time. Why? They respected the Lord. You know what? I miss the blue laws. I really do. Not when I was lost. When I was lost, I was aggravated because there was bored, nothing to do on Sunday, couldn't go nowhere. But after I got saved, realized everything shut down, and amen, people respected the word of God, and you know, our nation was blessed. And he says, and all these blessings shall come on thee and overtake thee, if thou shalt hearken unto the voice of the Lord thy God. Blessed shalt thou be in the city, and blessed shalt thou be in the field. Blessed shall be the fruit of thy body, and the fruit of thy ground, and the fruit of thy cattle, the increase of thy kind, and the flocks of thy sheep. Blessed shall be thy basket and thy store. Blessed shalt thou be when thou comest in, and blessed shalt thou be when thou goest out. The Lord shall cause thine enemies that rise up against thee to be smitten before thy face. They shall come out against thee one way and flee before thee seven ways. The Lord shall command a blessing upon thee and thy storehouses, and in all that thou settest thine hand unto. And he shall bless thee in the land which the Lord thy God giveth thee. You know, you think about the storehouses. Back when I was growing up, I left home, 15, 16, and I left Virginia and went up to New Jersey and went to work for a trucking company. And I remember we didn't have any money, and it was 2 weeks before we got a paycheck. So we got a piece of canvas, and we put it up by the river, and we'd take our baths in the river, and we'd bum 15 cents and get a bag of white beans and a piece of fat back, and cook that over a stove. You know, some good days. But we used to, I remember we got desperate. We'd bum some money. They had milk machines up there, and you could get milk out of them, half a gallon or whatever. And we'd get some milk, And we went into a warehouse one night, found a hole that the rats made big enough for all of us. Mm-hmm. And we were eating Cap'n Crunch peanut butter cereal before it got on the market. But, you know, America used to have warehouses. Then they got away from it. Now they got on-time delivery. Mm-hmm. And you realize what that's done? If we have a catastrophe in 2 weeks, there's no food on the shelves.
That's right.
Amen. Amen. People don't realize how vulnerable we are in this country right now. What happened? They forgot the blessings.
Amen.
He says, the Lord shall establish thee in holy people unto himself, as he hath sworn unto thee. If thou shalt keep the commandments of the Lord thy God and walk in his ways, and all the people of the earth shall see that thou art called by the name of the Lord, and they shall be afraid of thee. We used to be called the Christian nation. And the Lord shall make thee plenteous in goods, in the fruit of thy body, and the fruit of thy cattle, and in the fruit of thy ground, and in the land which the Lord sware unto thy fathers to give thee. The Lord shall open unto thee his good treasure, the heaven, to give the rain unto the land in his season, and to bless all the work of thine hand. Thou shalt lend unto many nations, and thou shalt not borrow. And the Lord shall make thee the head and not the tail, and thou shalt be above only, and thou shalt not be beneath. If that thou hearken unto the commandments of the Lord thy God, which I command thee this day to observe and to do them, thou shalt not go aside from any of the words which I command thee this day, to the right hand or to the left, to go after other gods, to serve them. But it shall come to pass that thou wilt not hearken unto the voice of the Lord thy God to observe to do all his commandments and his statutes, which I command thee this day, that all these curses shall come upon thee and overtake thee. Cursed shalt thou be in the city, and cursed shalt thou be in the field. Cursed shall be thy basket and thy store. Cursed shall be the fruit of thy body and the fruit of thy land, the increase of thy kind and the flocks of thy sheep. Cursed shalt thou be when thou comest in, and cursed shalt thou be when thou goest out. The Lord shall send upon thee cursing, vexation, and rebuke, in all that thou settest thine hand unto for to do, until thou be destroyed, and until thou perish quickly, because of the wickedness of thy doings, whereby thou hast forsaken me. The Lord shall make the pestilence cleave unto thee, until he hath consumed thee off the land whither thou goest to possess it. The Lord shall smite thee with a consumption, and with a fever, and with an inflammation, and with an extreme burning, and with the sword, and with blasting, and with mildew. They shall pursue thee until thou perish. And thy heaven that is over thy head shall be brass, and the earth that is under thee shall be iron. The Lord shall make the rain of the land powder and dust. From heaven shall it come down upon thee until thou be destroyed. The Lord shall cause thee to be smitten before thine enemies. Thou shalt go out one way against them and flee seven ways before them, and shall be removed into all the kingdoms of the earth. And thy carcass shall be meat unto all fowls of the air and unto the beasts of the earth, and no man shall fray them away. The Lord will smite thee with the botch of Egypt and with the emrods. If you don't know what that is, that's hemorrhoids. Amen. Amen. Remember, the Philistines made him some golden hemorrhoids and mice, amen, when they were returning the Ark of the Covenant, amen. And with the emeralds, and with the scab, and with the itch, whereof thou canst not be healed. The Lord shall smite thee with madness and blindness and astonishment of heart. Thou shalt grope at noonday as the blind gropeth in darkness. Thou shalt not prosper in thy ways, and thou shalt be only oppressed and spoiled evermore, and no man shall save thee. Thou shalt betroth a wife, and another man shall lie with her. Thou shalt build an house, and thou shalt not dwell therein. Thou shalt plant a vineyard, and shalt not gather the grapes thereof. Thine ox shall be slain before thine eyes, and thou shalt not eat thereof. Thine ass shall be violently taken away from before thy face, and shall not be restored to thee. Thy sheep shall be given unto thine enemies, and thou shalt have none to rescue them. Thy sons and thy daughters shall be given unto another people, and thine eyes shall look and fail with longing for them all the day long, and there shall be no might in thine hand. The fruit of thy land and all the labors shall a nation which thou knowest not eat up. Thou shalt be only oppressed and crushed alway, so that thou shalt be mad for the sight of thine eyes which thou shalt see. The Lord shall smite thee in the knees and in the legs with a sore botch that cannot be healed from the sole of thy foot unto the top of thy head. The Lord shall bring thee and thy king which thou shalt set over thee unto a nation which neither thou nor thy fathers have known, and there shalt thou serve other gods, wood and stone. Thou shalt become an astonishment, a proverb, and a byword among all nations whither the Lord shall lead thee. Thou shalt carry much seed out into the field, and shalt gather but little in, for the locust shall consume it. Thou shalt plant vineyards and dress them, but thou shalt neither drink of the wine nor gather the grapes, for the worms shall eat them. Thou shalt have olive trees throughout all thy coast, but thou shalt not anoint thyself with the oil, for thine olive shall cast its fruit. Thou shalt beget sons and daughters, but thou shalt not enjoy them, for they shall go into captivity. All thy trees and fruit of thy land shall the locust consume. The stranger that is within thee shall get up above thee very high, and thou shalt come down very low. He shall lend to thee, and thou shalt not lend to him. He shall be the head, and thou shalt be the tail. If you can't see some of these parables today in America, amen?
Amen.
I mean, you look at where we're at. We're borrowing. We're not lending. Crops, they're having problems with them everywhere. Amen. Our children are being consumed by the enemy. The arms and legs blowing off. Amen. Extended wars. The Bible says when a man's ways please the Lord, he maketh even his enemies to be at peace with him. They selling us out. We're slaves to the government. Amen.
Amen.
You work and labor, and then when you die, they want to get half of everything that your family owned. You don't think we're living in perilous times? We are. I look at the checks and what they deduct from everybody's paycheck. I mean, you make a few hours in the week and they take $100 and some for themselves. You'll never own any land. You're just paying rent. You're paying rent to the county. And then you buy a car or any kind of equipment, a Xerox machine, all these stuff. And what are you doing? You're paying for it forever. They tax everything. We're in bondage and people don't even realize it. The only thing about saying you own something, your own home, is that you can put your fist through the wall and nobody can say nothing about it. Amen. Verse 45, moreover, all these curses shall come upon thee and shall pursue thee and overtake thee till thou be destroyed, because thou hearkenest not unto the voice of the Lord thy God to keep his commandments and his statutes which he commanded thee. They shall be upon thee for a sign and for a wonder, and upon thy seed forever, because thou servest not the Lord thy God with joyfulness and with gladness of heart for the abundance of all things. Therefore shalt thou serve thine enemies, which the Lord shall send against thee, in hunger and in thirst, and in nakedness, and in want of all things. And he shall put a yoke of iron upon thy neck until he hath destroyed thee. The Lord shall bring a nation against thee from far. Hello, China. And from the end of the earth, as swift as the eagle flieth, a nation whose tongue thou shalt not understand. A nation of fierce countenance, which shall not regard the person of the old, nor show favor to the young. And he shall eat the fruit of thy cattle and the fruit of thy land until thou be destroyed, which also shall not leave thee neither corn, wine, or oil, or the increase of thy kind, or flocks of thy sheep until he hath destroyed thee. And he shall besiege thee in all the gates until thy high and fenced walls come down, wherein thou trustest throughout all thy land. And he shall besiege thee in all thy gates throughout all the land, all thy land which the Lord thy God hath given thee. Thou shalt eat the fruit of thine own body. You know, the Bible says, I didn't look it up again, I forget the reference, but it says, the fruit of my body for the sin of my soul. The fruit of my body for the sin of my soul. Thou shalt eat the fruit of thine own body, the flesh of thy sons and of thy daughters, which the Lord thy God hath given thee in the siege and in the straitness, wherewith thine enemies shall distress thee. So that the man that is tender among you and very delicate, his eyes shall be evil toward his brother, and toward the wife of his bosom, and toward the remnant of his children which he shall leave. So that he will not give to any of them the flesh of his children whom he shall eat. Can you imagine? Israel actually did this. They actually slaughtered and ate their own children in the siege. Because he hath nothing left him in the siege and in the straitness wherewith thine enemies shall distress thee in all thy gates. You know, you said, I could never do that. Oh, yeah, you could. Yeah, you could. Ask the folks up here at Donner's Pass one winter. At least it was cold enough to keep them on ice and they could just get a slice here and there. You'd be surprised what you could do. Or what you would do. Amen.
What they're doing today.
Now look at this in verse 56. The tender and delicate woman among you, which would not adventure to set the sole of her foot upon the ground for delicateness and tenderness. I'm talking about, you know, a fine lady, right? A tender and delicate woman. And it says, her eyes shall be evil toward the husband of her bosom, and toward her son, and toward her daughter, and toward her young one that cometh out from between her feet, and toward her children, which she shall bear, for she shall eat them for want of all things secretly in the siege and straitness, wherewith thine enemies shall distress thee in thy gates. If thou wilt not observe to do all the words of this law that are written in this book, that thou mayest fear this glorious and fearful name, the Lord thy God.
Amen.
You remember when they slaughtered one baby and not the other? Amen. We'll eat yours today and we'll eat mine tomorrow. You know why America's in such a mess? Our leaders and actually the churches. You know when the churches were faithful to God, faithful to the house of God, the country was strong. But little by little, these leftists got into the schools. They begin to brainwash your children. Remember when they started out with the cards, the garbage pail kids? Mm-hmm. Look at it now. They're murdering babies. They pull them all the way out the womb just about and stick a pair of scissors through the back of their skull and suck their brains out. The safest place there ever was in the womb of a mother. Now it's the most dangerous place in this country. We did it and we stood by. We allowed sodomy to run rampant. Instead of condemning it, they wanted to promote it. You know what happened to sodomites in the Old Testament? When Josiah got the word of God, he went in and destroyed the houses of the sodomites and them. Why? Because it sowed wickedness and wrought wickedness in the land. It brought a curse upon this country. People say, it's my own body. I can do what I want. It's mine. No, you affect everybody. What you and I do affects others around us. And we wouldn't stand up. We were too busy doing our thing. Then they started breaking down the family. Sexual immorality. It didn't just start in the 50s. Remember the Roaring 20s? You probably don't remember them. Well, you might. Then the 60s. Free love wasn't so free, was it? Then our politicians, the sorry, low-down scum of the earth that wouldn't stand up for nothing, just wanted to get reelected, just like that great sheriff over in Richland County, marching in a fag parade. I told him I used to respect him, but I don't have a bit for you now. Why is that, councilman? I said, marching in a fag parade with a gay necklace on? And he says, I have to be a sheriff unto all people. I said, then why weren't you standing with the preachers?
That's right.
And I asked him, I said, how old are you? And he told me, I said, you're my age. You grew up. You know this is wrong. You know it's wrong. I said, it's a shame you don't have the courage to stand up for what's right just to get a vote. He said, we'll just have to agree to disagree. But I tell you what, last 3 years he hasn't been in that parade. He's been out of town conveniently every year. Nobody wants to stand up. I mentioned it to some of the other council members. I said, you see that? They got upset with me. He's my friend. I said, I don't care if he's your brother.
That's right.
Wrong is wrong. I've heard the police in Columbia when we were at the parade say, oh, I just love the gays. I love these prides. And a friend of mine that was doing undercover stuff for Richland told me that half of that crowd over there is that way. That's what we've got. That's what's supposed to be protecting us. That's what's supposed to be protecting your children. We wonder why we have so much trouble with young people today. America's turned her back on God and morality.
Amen.
And listen, don't be so pious. There's no temptation taking you, but it's common to man. Some of you have had the same feelings, same thoughts. You just didn't do them. Amen. There's a lot of temptation. But you know what feeds it? The things that we watch, the things that we listen to. You think about what these young people are listening to. The music, so-called rap. Man, I was writing a rap song. You remember that?
No.
I was born white, but I want to be black. I wear my pants down around my crack. My hat's on backwards. I don't know which way to go. Amen. True, Andy. Didn't have the money to pay the bill for that nice little golden grill. Amen. Cheer up, Sambo. I'm going to be a rapper. Then he rapped all right. Duct tape.
Cracker.
Yeah. Cracker rapper. Man. I was walking into Ruby Tuesday's one day. This elderly black woman's there with her grandson or who it was, you know. He's all styling and profiling, you know, he's got the red cap, you know, like that. And he's got a red sweater on, red panties, amen, and red pants and red and white tennis shoes. And he's walking in there and I'm walking in there behind him. I said, fix mine. I was rapping. And anyway, there we go. And I said, hey, bud, your panties falling down. He said, Huh? I said, your panties, they're falling down. Oh. Then I left my wife there when I went. Hey, man, they're just sitting there. The granny was, whoever she was, just kept. She should have told him pull his pants up.
That's right.
Amen. Man, anybody want to see your dirty underwear? My goodness. I want to get me some a pea shooter or something, you know. Goodness. Hit the bullseye. Poof. Amen. Wouldn't that be fun, huh? Yeah. I told him, I said this. I said, you know where they got that at, don't they? Don't you? Huh? I said, you know where they got that, don't you? In prison. So you'd let them know you're available.
For real?
Yeah, for real. Hey. Are you available? You know, Israel went through all this. We go over to Jeremiah. Jeremiah chapter 1. Well, you know, the problem today is nobody will say anything about this junk. They let them do it. Just checking. Amen. All right. Hey, do you enjoy your religion?
Amen.
How about your salvation?
Amen.
Amen.
If you want my preacher.
Yeah. Don't laugh if you see the Concord label come out. Jeremiah chapter 1. And I'll be brief. Not the Fruit of Loom rush. Amen. Yeah, I don't know about you, but I get embarrassed when things happen like that. You know, I was preaching Derek's grandfather's funeral down in Florida. And we got up early one morning and I drove straight to Jacksonville. And the church has heard this a couple times, but I needed a place to change. And I go in there and I asked this guy, you know, I think it was the grandson or nephew of the undertaker. It was a black funeral parlor, busted lights, whatever they had coming out the vent for odor was disgusting. And I asked for a place where I could get changed, and he takes me back here into the slab room. And he looked like the guy was drinking most of the formaldehyde rather than putting it in the bodies. And, you know, and he kind of walked like that. And he said, I followed him, took me in the slab room. Then he goes, pulled me back, took me into this little restroom. And it was so small, it's about this size, it's actually smaller than behind the pulpit here. And the door wouldn't close all the way. And he went over there in that corner and sat in a chair like that and watched me. And anyway, I shut the lights off real quick, put my pants on, turned the light back on. Amen. I called him the formaldehyde kid and pulled my pants back up. And I'm trying to pull my sock on. I reach down and go to pull my sock up, and my foot goes through the heel. And I drop my tie clasp, so I bent over like this, and one end of me hit the wall, and the other end hit this wall. And finally, I stretched down like that, and the whole seat of my pants went. I didn't bring another pair. I walked out there like that. I looked like Peter Cottontail. Black pants, white tail. Always remember, young people, make sure you wear clean underwear. That's what my mom used to tell me. It paid off this time. And I got out there, and I'm walking out there. At least I had my big Bible with me. I'm walking like this. And I get out there, and I'm preaching. I had the coffin laid out and a flag over it. And I'm standing against the wall, and I'm preaching, "He ain't here! He ain't here!" And his daughter's out there. 1 minute she's laughing, next minute she's crying. And anyway, I'm hitting on the coffin. The flag falls off, and it says 9:95. Amen. And every time I said he ain't here, the funeral director's sitting in the back going, Come to find out he wasn't there. He's laying in the slab room. I was never so glad to get out of there, but I didn't tell you the whole story. I might tell you that one about Derek one day. But 1960 polyester green bell-bottom, lime green bell-bottom pants on all the way up to his ankles, and a white shirt over top of a t-shirt with big red letters underneath. It was a trip, Russ. It was a trip.
He never was a fashion conscious dude.
No, he never was fashion conscious. But anyway, how'd I get on that? I don't know. Jeremiah chapter 1. The words of Jeremiah, the son of Hilkiah, of the priests that were at Anathoth in the land of Benjamin, to whom the word of the Lord came in the days of Josiah, the son of Amon, king of Judah, in the 13th year of his reign. It came also in the days of Jehoiakim, the son of Josiah, king of Judah, until the end of the 11th year of Zedekiah, the son of Josiah, king of Judah, unto the carrying away of Jerusalem captive in the fifth month. Then the word of the Lord came unto me, saying, Before I formed thee in the belly, I knew thee. And before thou camest forth out of the womb, I sanctified thee, and I ordained thee a prophet unto the nations. Then said I, O Lord God, behold, I cannot speak, for I am a child. But the Lord said unto me, Say not, I am a child, for thou shalt go to all that I shall send thee. And whatsoever I command thee, thou shalt speak. Be not afraid of their faces, for I am with thee to deliver thee, saith the Lord. Then the Lord put forth his hand and touched my mouth. And the Lord said unto me, Behold, I have put my words in thy mouth. See, I have this day set thee over the nations and over the kingdoms to root out and to pull down and to destroy and to throw down and to build and to plant. Moreover, the word of the Lord came unto me, saying, Jeremiah, what seest thou? I said, I see a rod of an almond tree. Then said the Lord unto me, Thou hast well seen, for I will hasten my word to perform it. And the word of the Lord came unto me the second time, saying, What seest thou? And I said, I see a seething pot, and the face thereof is toward the north. Then the Lord said unto me, Out of the north an evil shall break forth upon all the inhabitants of the land. For lo, I will call all the families of the kingdoms of the north, saith the Lord. They shall come, they shall set every one in his throne at the entering of the gates of Jerusalem, and against all the walls thereof round about, and against all the cities of Judah. And I will utter my judgments against them, touching all their wickedness who have forsaken me, and have burned incense unto other gods, and worshipped the works of their own hands. Thou therefore gird up thy loins, and arise, and speak unto them all that I command thee. Be not dismayed at their faces, lest I confound thee before them. Listen, that's some serious stuff. I mean, if you've ever been in a church with 300, 400, 500 people, and you're preaching on sin, you ought to see some of the faces. If looks can kill, you'd be dead. Amen. I know when I was preaching the funeral of Miss Marie's dad down there in Gaston at First Baptist, all them people sitting there. And when I told that woman, I said, What are you crying for? You shot him. Amen. Well, some people gave me some dirty looks. But you know what? When I walked out to the graveyard, some people came up to me. I'm glad you said that. Amen. But you look at some faces, people give you some nasty looks while you're preaching. You know why? It's usually because something you said hit them.
I bet she gave you a dirty one.
Yeah, she was half lit anyway. So what are you crying about? You shot him before. Man. I was preaching a funeral in Leesville at the Methodist Church, and I was having a good time, and I turned around, I said, man, that ought to make a Methodist shout. I turned around, looked at the pastor, I said,
oh, Lord.
People give you some strange looks, like I'm getting now. Amen. Okay. He said, lest I confound thee before them, for behold, I have made thee this day a defense city and an iron pillar and brazen walls against the whole land, against the kings of Judah, against the princes, against the priests thereof, and against the people of the land. They shall fight against thee, but they shall not prevail against thee. Now look at this, for I am with thee, saith the Lord, to deliver thee. Now he's saying this to Jeremiah, and the guy was smacked around. He was put in a dungeon, fed bread and water, and he said, are you still really with me? I mean, could you imagine that? Make you wonder, huh? But the Lord was with him. Look over in verse 8 of chapter 2. Look at some of the problem. The priest said not, where is the Lord? They that handled the law knew me not. The pastors also transgressed against me, and the prophets prophesied by Baal, and walked after things that do not profit. You know, today they're looking for a private jet, $1,000 silk suits. Amen. They're looking for some golf buddies. I'm talking about some independent Baptist churches, too. They send our people off to a college somewhere, and instead of training them up in their own church, they take them out of our community. And what you have left is people that want to be entertained. Am I doing all right? Amen. The problem today in America is really not the politicians, it's the preachers, it's the churches. We failed to do our job. You know, there used to be a time where they'd be afraid to open any kind of illicit, immoral place of business because of the churches, because the churches stood up, because they gave themselves to prayer. They cared about their community. They cared about their loved ones. But today, I was talking to somebody the other day, we don't even know our neighbors. How long have you lived where you're living now? Have you gone door to door? Have you passed out a gospel tract? Have you introduced yourself, invited them to church? That's what's wrong with America. We're only interested in ourselves, most of us. But you know, the good thing is, if Biden gets in, you ought to rejoice. Be happy. Because the time of our redemption draweth nigh. It's set up for the Antichrist.
Yes, it is.
If God gives us President Trump 4 more years, it's just going to postpone it. But God is in charge. He moves the hearts of people. And you know, whether we like it or not, whoever he puts in, it was the Lord that did it. And he has a purpose to fulfill his prophecy, to fulfill his will. And America doesn't deserve President Trump, to be honest with you. We're murdering our babies, all this ungodliness. I used to give a pass to missionaries' kids and preachers' kids because they see a lot of hypocrisy. But you know what I figured out? They've still got a Bible too. They know what's right and what's wrong. They're rebellious. I remember Brother Phil Kidd had a preacher friend, and Tony Esposito had a boys' place out in Splendor, Texas. And they went to the streets. They used to go down to Houston and try to get the children that's running away from home, get them off the bus and get them before the chicken hawks do. But he was showing a film, and out on the street, there was this kid with one of them Doberman collars, you know, with the spikes around his neck, on a leash, and a black man holding it. He was pimping them off. And you know what? Phil says, wait a minute, stop that, back it up. He said, I know him. That was a preacher friend of his son, 16 years old, that ran away. And they were using him as a male prostitute. Put a collar on his neck and a leash, like an animal. You know what his problem was? Rebellion against his dad, against what they stood for. He wanted the world, wanted to go have fun. How's that working for you? How's that working for you? I used to have people close to me would say something about God or the church or the reason I don't do this. No, the reason you're not doing right is because you're a stinking rebel. You're a rebel. You're rebellious. You're self-willed. And you're on your way to hell. The trouble is, we got people that know better condoning it.
Amen.
Condoning it. Because they don't care either, because they got their own rebel nature. I get excited since these young folks have been coming. You know why? Because they're our future. We need them. Even you, Sambo. But you know what children are looking for? They're looking for somebody to care. They're looking for somebody to actually spend time with them and love them. But the world will just use them and abuse them and think they're having fun. This is a wicked world. God warned against it. He said, he talked about the fruit of our bodies. The fruit of our bodies, our children, our youth. We sat back and let these communists and socialists and everything else infiltrate our schools and fill their head with garbage. Mm-hmm. Remember when they come out trying to teach, I'm talking about middle school kids, how to have safe sex? You remember that? What is wrong with them? We've left God. We've failed. We're so busy doing everything else. Some people so busy trying to save the world, they lose their own. We start at home. We get right with God. We obey the word of God. And we train up our children the best we can. Well, does that mean they're going to turn out right? Not all the time. But you do your best. One thing about me other preachers really don't like, well, there's probably a whole lot of things they don't like, but a lot of things they don't like about me is I'm too open with my feelings. In other words, I'll tell you my failures. I'll tell you my problems, my temptation. But see, they act like they have none. I'm a human. Some will dispute that, but I am. We've lived a life of, well, honestly, we've had a good life for our own rebellion in our own life. I hated authority. You know where that starts? In the home. The Bible says that foolishness is bound in the heart of a child, but the rod of correction shall drive it far from him. It said, beat him with a rod. That won't kill him. thou shalt deliver their soul from hell. But instead, you know what we did? If you don't behave, I'm going to make you sit in the corner with a dunce hat on. I don't whip my children. I love them too much. No, the Bible says if you won't chase them, you hate them. Putting a dunce hat on a kid in school. You remember when they used to do that? Set you in the school in the corner. Yeah, especially up north. You may have had a lot of dunces. And but they set you in the corner and put that little dunce hat on you. Try to embarrass you in front of people. That didn't take away the rebellion and the foolishness. It took a rod. Amen. The rod of correction. You know what God does to his children when they step out of line? Puts a rod on them. You know, you don't see much chastening in the churches anymore. Where's the joy of the Lord in your heart? It's all poor me. Nobody knows the trouble I've seen. Amen? Man, suck it up. Get right with God. Still happy? We let our children get ruined because we were too busy doing what we wanted to do. You know how the churches are today? In the summertime, I guarantee you, half the congregation has their bathing suits on. They pull their boat behind them to church, and they back into the parking space so they can be the first ones out. But they're coming to worship the Lord on the Lord's Day. If you want to get mad at anybody for the state that we're in, it's our own fault. It's our own fault. Israel wouldn't hearken. The Lord even had Jeremiah tell him, if you just go there, I mean, if you just give up, do what you're supposed to do, you can eat your own food in your own land and your own houses. Amen? But they wouldn't. So they got taken into Babylon in captivity. But you know, Daniel went in there, and Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, amen. They went in there and they served the Lord in a strange land. They took care of the king. Can you imagine Nehemiah? He had to be a taster for the king. Here, see if there's any poison in this one. Amen. But yet he honored the king. You know, even in captivity, Nehemiah had a relationship with God just like Daniel and the others. And he heard what was going on in the city and how bad a shape it was in. And the king noticed his countenance wasn't his joyful self when he was tasting the king's wine to see if there was poison in it. Amen. And he asked him what was wrong. And Nehemiah was so prayed up that all he had to do was say, I prayed unto God and said unto the king. And you know the king granted him his desires. You know who moved his heart? God did. You know why? On behalf of Nehemiah. We may not like what's coming our way, but one thing you can be sure of, God's still in control. He said he would set a table for us in famine, in a drought. He said he'd take care of us. Make sure you do your part, but put God first when you do. You know what this tells me? The end is coming. You better get your loved ones and your family in. You ought to be excited. Did you look at some of the picks that Biden's putting back in, if he gets in? You don't think this country's over if he's there?
He's already doomed it.
Huh?
Was already doomed it up.
But God's still in control. We have to remember that. I was going to take you over to Job. Job is a picture of Israel in the last half of the tribulation. Amen? Forty-two chapters in the book of Job. Job was maintaining his own self-righteousness all the way through. But when he gets over to chapter 42 and verse 5, he says, I have heard of thee by the hearing of the ear, but now mine eyes seeth thee. Wherefore I abhor myself and repent in dust and ashes. Israel's been a very proud nation. The first 3.5 years, the first 42 months of the tribulation period, they're going to make a covenant with the Antichrist. Everything's going to be wonderful. Boy, when you see the Middle East and Israel making all these peace agreements, it's coming. But you know what the good thing is? We won't be here. We're going out. If you're saved, you won't be here. The second half of the tribulation period is a picture. Job pictures that, the suffering, the pain, the trouble. Israel and their self-righteousness, the justifying herself. But when Job gets to the 42nd chapter, he finally sees God. He's made his complaint all the way through. And he was a good man. He helped people. I mean, you go back and read it. But when he gets there, he actually gets a glimpse of what God, who God is, and he sees how vile he is. You know, before a person gets saved, they got to see themselves as vile as Job saw himself. Long as you're maintaining your own self-righteousness, that's all you've got. Long as you can find somebody that's living a little lower than you, so you can lift yourself up, you'll never get saved. I remember the day I was under conviction. I was on a missionary trip. The plane landed at Eagle Aviation. I was under conviction. And I went in there and said, Lord, if I got to be as good as you to get to heaven, and if I break one, I'm guilty of all, how am I going to get there? He said, for by grace are you saved through faith, and that not of yourselves is the gift of God, not of works, lest any man should boast. And I said, Lord, if I'm going, you got to take me. There is no other way. See, before I was doing good deeds. I was helping the poor. I was going to the streets with the rest of the people. We were preaching and passing out tracts. But I had to get lost before I'd get found. Israel's going to do that in a day. When the Lord comes back with us on the Mount of Olives, and they say, where'd you get the wounds in your hands and your feet? And by the way, they're not scars, they're wounds. And he's going to say, in the house of my friends, and in that day, in a moment, all Israel as a nation will be saved. They can get saved now individually. They can receive the Messiah. But as a nation, they'll turn to God in that day. But they're going to have to go through some things. Jeremiah chapter 6, and I'm done. In verse 16. Thus saith the Lord, stand ye in the ways, and see, and ask for the old paths, where is the good way? And walk therein, and ye shall find rest for your souls. But they said, we will not walk therein. You want rest for your souls? Seek the old paths. Go the good way. Don't be one of those that said, we will not walk therein. Amen? You want peace in your heart? You want joy in your life? You're going to have to do it by the book. There's no shortcuts either. And there's a God that loved you so much that he sent his only begotten son to die for you and suffer in hell so you could be redeemed.
Life.
Have everlasting life. That's right, Derek. How about you? Have you received them? You want peace in your life? And quit playing the blame game. You're what you make yourself. Amen? I didn't do a bad job on my own. Amen. All right, well, I'm like a hard-boiled egg. I'm done. Brother Dave, if you would be so kind, so that we could let my people go as well.
Lord, God, I'm saying, Lord, again, we do thank you for this day. We do thank you for the preaching hour, Lord. Gave us a lot of stuff to think about and to ponder upon, Lord God, and that's what it's all about, Lord. Father, I do pray, Lord God, that you look after each and every one of us. Put a hedge about us, Lord, and our loved ones, Lord. And Father, guide us and guard us till we meet at the next appointed time. And we thank you and praise you, Lord Jesus Christ. Name we pray. Amen.
Man, I was going to read you something that Stalin and them said, how they dethroned God. I read it to the church one time. Maybe I'll do that Wednesday.